American best-selling young adult novelist Jennifer Niven is in town to sign books for her fans this weekend. She joins us this morning to tell us about this event and her latest book, All the Bright Places. Good morning and welcome to the show, Jennifer.
Thank you.
And welcome to the Philippines.
Oh, thank you. It's wonderful to be here.
Just got in yesterday, and yes. What's great is you're going to be here for quite a while, so you'll actually get some FaceTime with fans.
So excited. So excited. My Filipino readers are the most amazing readers in the world.
Oh, that's really nice to hear. I know in times when, you know, some authors are able to kind of pass through, they always say that Filipino readers are very active on social media.
Yes.
They'll let you know what they think, kind of their questions.
Absolutely. I feel like that's this wonderful family.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. It really is. We're quite vocal on social media.
I love that.
Love to show our love on there. All right, well, let's talk about what brings you to the Philippines.
Okay.
Which is All the Bright Places.
Yes.
This is something, I guess, you know, if it's a first for your fans to see you, it's also kind of a first experience of sorts for you, as this is your first young adult fiction novel. Yeah.
That's right. Absolutely. This is, you know, it's my eighth book, but it's my first young adult. And it's been this completely overwhelming, wonderful experience, mm-hmm. and one I didn't really anticipate going into it, mm-hmm. because the story really just comes from a personal place, and it's a story I didn't know I could write because it was so personal, so I took a long time to get to it. And I'm so glad that I finally did, and it's just been, as I said, it's been a really overwhelming, mm-hmm. wonderful experience.
We were just kind of chatting as to how you got into a young adult, mm-hmm. This young adult novel, because you started off completely in a different journey with two nonfiction books,
right.
And then you were writing your adult novels, and then yeah. Please tell us, you know, why you made the change.
I made the change the summer of 2013. I lost my literary agent of 15 years, very unexpectedly, mm-hmm. and I was talking to new agents, and I was thinking about what I wanted to do next. And I kept hearing this conversation that he and I had, the last conversation we had, which was about my next project. And he said, whatever you do next, I want you to write it with your whole heart, because you can't imagine writing anything else. And so I thought about that. I thought about how I've always admired young adult literature. I've always read it. And I have this personal story about this boy that I loved years ago. And I had always wanted to do something with it, but I didn't know how or when, and mm-hmm. I decided to just try it and see what would happen if I wrote it.
I see. Okay. And, you know, I mean, young adult novels have really kind of taken off also in recent years. I mean, being made into movies, being kind of really taking center stage in pop culture.
They have.
Was that something in the back of your mind when you decided to write all the Bright Places?
You know, it wasn't. I've always read young adult, and mm-hmm. I've always really admired more and more and more so what they're doing in young adult literature. Mm-hmm. I think so many things are being talked about bravely and honestly, topics that need to be discussed, and I wanted to be a part of that. But
did you read, I imagine young adult as a young adult.
Absolutely.
But even as an adult, you still kind of continue to tap into those stories.
Absolutely, and I think I always say, you know, I think it's because inside I'm 15. So
I can relate, you know.
Okay.
I know. I just finished rewatching Gossip Girl, so I understand.
I love Gossip Girl, and my favorite show is Supernatural, as most of my readers know.
So I understand. There's still kind of a piece of myself that I can relate
right.
to that. That, you know, you feel like you're just still in high school.
Absolutely.
Maybe some of the issues that young adult readers and the characters of young adult novels mm-hmm. that they still have then. You know, maybe those are still kind of the same issues that we have now as adults, but with a different name and a little bit of an evolution.
It's absolutely true, and I think there's so many universal things that are dealt with in young adult literature mm-hmm. that we can relate to, and it's one reason I think that 55% of young adult literature readers mm-hmm. are adults.
Mm-hmm.
I
mm-hmm.
think it's because it's timeless.
It is, and it brings you back also to a time, like you were saying, you know, this story is very personal, you know, to you, so it's actually kind of, it's actually like your fans are learning more about you,
yes.
kind of a deeper take into this story, and as yourself as well, and, you know, you're able to kind of go back and reminisce, maybe, and think
absolutely.
About that. Yeah.
Absolutely.
So the character in the book, Finch, Thomas mm-hmm. Finch and Violet, mm-hmm. You know, they meet and they kind of go through quite an experience on top of on top of a six-story
bell tower ledge at high school. Uh-huh. That's right. Finch and Violet meet atop the ledge of this bell tower as they're both up there contemplating jumping off. Mm. And the first line of the novel is today a good day to die? And it's in Finch's voice. I alternate, you know, voices in the book. And really, Finch talks Violet off that ledge, but everyone thinks it's the other way around because he's kind of the school freak, and he's known to do very unexpected, weird things, and Violet is kind of popular and well-liked, and so no one knows that the truth is actually the other way around.
Mm-hmm. And it kind of puts more attention on the fact that, you know, some young people may not be as happy as we assume
Absolutely.
That they are, or mm-hmm. It takes a kind of a deeper look as to the need for a deeper look for what young people are really feeling, what they're really wanting to say.
Absolutely. And you know, there were some adults when the book first came out who said they wish that I wouldn't write about something like this because they don't want teens to know that it exists, essentially. Mm-hmm. They want them to think about those things later in life. Mm-hmm. But I'm hearing from the children of those same adults who are saying, I don't feel like I'm heard, I feel like I'm all alone, mm-hmm. I'm struggling, I don't know what's happening and why I feel this way. And your book made me feel, and Finch and Violet made me feel like I'm not alone. Mm-hmm. And that is, you know, the most, it's so sad that so many people feel that way, but it's the most amazing feedback because I feel like it's doing good. The book is doing good and, mm-hmm. and helping start conversations that need to be started.
And those are conversations that are taking place all over the world. I know you're far from home, you're far from the U.S., but maybe the same struggle that obviously young adults are having there, could be having here with different things, obviously, different
circumstances. And again, it's universal.
Yeah, and so to reach out to your readers, whether they be young adults or not,
right?
makes sense. Any part of the world that struggle, and also
Absolutely.
To give that bit of hope that those two didn't jump off.
Absolutely, absolutely. And I think that's so important, especially when you're writing about issues like this. It's important to say, you know, it's okay, and it's also important for you to talk about this, mm-hmm. and you're not alone, and mm-hmm. there is hope, and to offer that hope the story.
Yeah, I mean, a reply to the parents who kind of expressed that worry of talking about
right.
this and bringing it to the forefront of their kids' minds, but also saying, you want to talk about it before
yes.
you can't.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. It's important.
Well, thank you, because I know that's a very, you put your vulnerable self out there when you
yes.
share something like this. So really, thank you for doing that.
Thank you.
If people want to, obviously meet you in person, and maybe will you be talking at the book signing, or have some time to chat with the fans?
I will, absolutely. And I'm just so excited. And I have the information about
yes,
the book
that would
signing.
Be great. Where can people check you out?
They can check me out. I'm going to be in Cebu, mm-hmm. and May 28th, 1 p.m. North Wing Atrium, SM City, Cebu. Mm-hmm. And then here in Manila, May 29th, 2 p.m. Second Level Mega Atrium at the SM Mega Mall.
Fantastic.
And registration starts at 10 a.m. for both events.
Okay. Well, I'm mm-hmm. glad that you made your way all the way over here. Love the nails. They're so fun.
All the right places nails.
I
and
know.
A ring that a reader made me, too.
Oh, wow. Okay. Well, I'm sure that some of your readers will be coming to the event with some gifts from the Philippines as well. Hopefully, you'll be able to take those home with you. But once again, all the bright places. And you will be in Cebu. So you leave tonight.
That's
and,
right.
And we flash the schedule as well. Where do they
good.
Get tickets or invites?
All the Right Places is available at National Bookstore, uh-huh. and Power Books, and online at nationalbookstore.com. Mm-hmm. So I believe that they have that.
Okay, and then when they go into to the book signing, it's they can just pop in. Do they need to register anywhere? Oh, they
registration
great.
At 10 a.m.
Registration at
yes.
10 a.m. Just get yourself there. Thank you so much,
yes.
Jennifer, and thank you for
you.
Sharing, your book. The story behind it, and enjoy your time in the Philippines.
Thank
Hope
you
to see
so
you back.
It's wonderful to be here, and thank you so much to my readers. I love you more than words.
Great.